In the last lecture, I derived the triple product rule. So we didn't really have a chance to fully digest it. So let me show you a simple example where it applies. That's the ideal gas law. Many of you might have seen this in a chemistry course. This is PV equals nRT. So P is the pressure of the gas, V is its volume, T is its temperature. So those are the variables. N is the number of moles, and R is the ideal gas law constant. Okay. So the N and R are constants. So P, V, and T are variables. So if you remember when I derived the triple product rule, I said that there's a function of the variables P, V, and T, which is equal to zero. That function would simply be PV minus nRT, and that's zero, okay? So there's a relationship, one relationship between the three variables, PV and T. So we can write P as a function of V and T. We can write V as a function of P and T, or we can write T as a function of P or and V, okay? So one of these variables can be written as a function of the other two. So we want to see what these functions are. So here, P equals a function of V and T. So P is equal to solving the ideal gas law for P. We would get nRT divided by V. V is a function of P and T. So solving the ideal gas law for V, we would get V equals nRT over P. And then T is a function of P and V, so we would get T is equal to PV over nR, okay? Okay, so let's compute this triple product. So the triple product would be, recall what the triple product rule is. So triple product rule. Would be that the derivative of P with respect to V times the derivative of V with respect to T times the partial derivative of T with respect to P should equal to negative 1. Okay, that's the triple product rule. Remember, the V's and the T's and the P's don't cancel. We get minus 1. So let's compute these derivatives and see if it works. So the partial derivative of P with respect to V is, this is V to the minus 1, so minus V to the minus 2, so minus nRT over V squared. The partial derivative of V with respect to T, it's linear in T, so it's just nR over P. And the partial derivative of T with respect to P, it's also linear in P, so it's just V over nR, right? So remember, when we take the partial of P with respect to V, we hold T fixed. When we take the partial of V with respect to T, we all hold P fixed. And when we take the partial of T with respect to P, we hold V fixed. Okay? Sometimes you write that explicitly, but we won't do that here. So let's take the product now to get the triple product. So we have dP dV times dV dT times dT dP equals minus nRT over V squared nr over p and v over nr, okay? Some of these things have to cancel, right? So this squared here cancels this v, this nr cancels this nr, so we end up with minus nrt over p times v, okay? Nrt over pv. But pv is equal to nrt. That's the ideal gas law. Pv equals nrt, so this is minus 1. We're stuck with that minus sign, okay? A demonstration of the triple product rule for the case of the ideal gas law. So let me review. I like teaching the triple product rule because it gives a demonstration of differentials in the proof as well as partial derivatives. And it shows you that these partial derivatives are tricky items, okay? They're not like usual derivatives of a function of single variables. It's not a delta p divided by delta v where you can cancel the delta v's and the delta p's. They're a different animal. Partial of p with respect to v has a meaning that you keep partial of v with respect, partial of p with respect to v has the meaning that you keep t fixed. Partial v with respect to t has a meaning that you keep p fixed. And partial t with respect to p has a meaning that you keep v fixed. That's a different animal than a function of a single variable and a normal derivative. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.